Who is Bandor Key?
Should I tell them who I was or who I'm gonna be? I used to ride pedal bikes and do robberies. My girl said I'm involved, I told my bitch obviously. From Boardwater Farm, I love the block of B. You gotta be a real one. And I ain't got no rebar, I got a real gun. I know a nigga with a whack that will still run. I look my brother in his eyes, cause somebody has to die. I said, my why'd you over there to go endure one? And that's the truth.
Bandor Key is Kamani Duggan, I'm 22, I'm a rapper from Boardwater Farm. Throughout all my life, but I've had good times, so probably from when I was just younger to now, you get it. Life was hard, then life was easy, so it's kind of split, but like, the reason why I say hard, because of like police, and fucking, yeah, just other stuff still. Then I've just had my good times. Yeah. I'm not the bad guy everyone thinks I am, I'm a good guy at times. It's literally, yeah.
How long have you known Bandor?
For years, Storm. Yeah. From juveniles, like, yeah. Kid days, you know what I'm saying?
I know Bandor from when he was young, still when he was a little youth, still.
Since he was a baby. Yeah. You know what I mean? And Bandor's same age because of my little brother. So literally, Bandor's my little brother, that's family. And yeah, man, from the jump, from the beginning. Before music, before anyone knew about music or like any of us knew about music. You know what I mean?
Cool. What was he like back then?
Stiff face, he always had that stiff face of his, man.
Energetic.
Funny story, like, I remember getting messages from him, like, probably like 12 on Facebook, and he's messaging me, like, still gas, like, you get me, I was a younger, like.
I've known Bandor for years, man. Bro, man's known him since he was a youth, man, to be honest, but when we proper started chatting, was like, when he was like 11, 10, 11, probably.
Okay.
I remember back in the day, I never forget, I was like probably like 10 these times now.
Yeah.
Bands try to stick one up with a pellet gun in this park right here as well. In this very park here. Him, little Kajon, Daps, and Baz.
Crazy.
When I was like 10, bro.
Ah, Rick the G is still.
What's your relationship like with Daps?
That's my guy. Besides music, you get me? Just from me being young. We was going to the same youth club, you know. You get me? We're just going there, just seeing him. And then, yeah, he's from the block, innit? So it's just natural.
Come, let's get in the block, man.
Let's go. Show me around the block, bro.
Sorry, Unks.
I used to live in that block there, Tanzania.
Mm-hmm.
My grandparents, obviously, this is when I was first born. My mum staying with my dad, Bams, and then yeah. Then I moved to like one road. Oh wait, that's where my mum lived with me in a hostel.
Mm-hmm.
Where I was first growing up. Yeah, just went from.
Yeah.
For me, Boardwater Farm's like home, kind of like our own playground. If that makes sense, yeah. Well, I knew that place was mad, bro.
From how old?
See, man, get shot when I was 10 years old, 11 years old. I've always known farm's a bad place, not for us or any good people, but just in general. But then when I first witnessed, you get me? That's when I was like, rah, this is mad, this place is mad still. And I had no hopes in making it to even where I am now. Then your ambush just got like a million views in a day.
I'm trying to do it like books, things blazing the hoods, but they got broski on the case. The shotgun come long like grace, half a half bit, so it comes in a rave. On the stage,
ambush was, yeah, man, that was a game changer. Funny enough, I was there. We put Bandor, myself, Els, and SJ together in a session with Sykes. Do you know what I mean? And this is what I'm saying, this is before anything was jumping in. That's what it is, the man them always roll together, go studio together. And I remember when they made that song and I was like, fucking up, this is a hit. Do you know what I mean? And I'll be honest, from there, they never looked back.
I was at the video shoot still.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was in jail when the video shoot still.
Yeah? So but did you man expect it to do what it did?
Yeah, I definitely bro, still.
100%.
Yeah. That tune, I knew that song, it was mad, I knew it was gonna do something, man, still.
Right, the whole summer, trust me, I was hearing that song.
Man.
Come on, man, that was
free
an anthem, bro.
Come on,
that's
free F. 100%. Come on,
you know that's an anthem.
Man was there, man was actually there, the video shoot, everything, but man weren't really in this music thing, you know what I'm saying? Man was more doing other things more time. You get them times just come out of jail and that, like, bros them are doing music and they will feel stuff. Man's coming out to that like, madnesses, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to their studio sessions when they're getting shopping, man's getting shopping, when they're getting to their shows, man's with them more time, rolling it.
Did you think it would do what it was going to do?
I didn't even know, man, I didn't even know, but obviously I just knew that, you get me, the man was doing cold, innit?
Yeah.
The man were all cold naturally, so more time, like, when I see the unexpected, it's like, rah, he was cold from the start anyway, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. I was in the studio with them when they was recording Ambush. I was doing it back to back on the same mic, me and my manager. Remember, we was in somewhere in East Central. It's the early days, and all the managers in the studio. I had a studio, a producer session in the main studio, and then they was recording it in the other studio, and then and my manager was telling them, yo, you lot just do the back-to-back thing, innit? And then yeah, it was cold, Sax Beats was in there as well. Yeah, man, that was lit.
Well, to be honest, I didn't really like Ambush before it dropped, if I'm being honest. Obviously, Els and SJ, they liked it, everyone else liked it. I just felt like, yeah, it wasn't the one, but it was.
We're going to get on to SJ, but before we do, yeah, tell us about that day, that session itself, because I'm sure you remember it.
No, cool. Yeah, I just remember going to the studio, innit? Obviously, flicking through a couple beats. That beat come on, and then I think me and Els was even taking long to write bars, and then, yeah, S just went in and just set pace. But there's been times when I'm writing bars and I'm hearing S go crazy, you just have to delete that and go again. Reality. Obviously, I preferred making music with the trio. You get me? Els just do his thing, because obviously Els is calm and he raps. But yeah, me and S were just mad competitive. You know what I'm saying? Because whatever he says was cold, and I was just trying to say anything to sound colder. We got locked for murder, piss. Bro was a well-known lurker. That day should I burn up. Band okay, I'm a real cat. He made me work harder with my music because he's a genius. Do you get it? Like, so me just hearing him just made me want to write and sound better than him. Not in a jealous way, but you're my brother, but doing this together, it's gonna work out for us the same age again.
Cool, we're gonna actually go on to SJ properly now. I asked Emmanuel about him.
A big part of that is obviously SJ.
Yeah, SJ as well.
Yeah, he's gonna win now.
Yeah, man, free him up.
For sure. Yeah, obviously, how you man felt at the time, like, was it just like, fuck's sake?
Yeah,
like,
man, it was more than just fuck's sake, because never just rapping, like, bro, man, like, niggas on the block actually grew up with SJ, so it was like a family, it's like losing another brother, innit? So bro's locked in the system right now. All we can most do is look after him and make sure his family's straight, he's straight, and then hopefully comes out, man.
S was cool, that music as well. I think I got like one song with SJ before I went to jail. Never had no video or nothing, but SJ was cold, you feel me? And when I went to jail and I used to hear them, like, you get me? Obviously, I already knew Bandlord's music a lot, but SJ's music was more new to me, but I thought, yo, S is talking some stuff, you get me? He's naturally talented, you feel me?
Everyone has their story, innit? Like, it's a young brother, big up SJ, just trying to do his thing, do you know what I mean? Just caught between two lines, as you say, innit? But, yeah, man, SJ's talented, and that's what was showing at the time and would always show anyways. It's just his talent. His talent was just effortless.
Yeah.
It wasn't someone that had to practice to do what he does. It's just boom. Yeah. SJ, crazy, do you know what I mean? And in the short space of time, like you said, it didn't take too long. It took 5 seconds and you're like, yep, another superstar.
And he could kick ball as well.
Everything, man, it's talent, do you know what I mean? Everyone's got God given talent from blessings, do you know what I mean? So yeah, man, that's what it was.
Well, and I think that's a good point, like, even about SJ, like, obviously when he went away, like, how did you guys feel about that?
Coming out, but I had him before, innit? It was upsetting.
Yeah.
Upsetting. Yeah, same with Boogie.
Free Boogie as well, man.
Free
all my life, bro. You get it.
Free
everyone.
I was in the Tim Westwood. Rapping. And then obviously someone on the block looks exactly like SJ. And the feds have come then and have arrested him, talking about he's arrested for murder and that. And then, but SJ is obviously with us at the crib session, and then, yeah. Told him, and then that's when we all knew, so that. Probably gonna arrest him. Since outside no bagel, fuck a bagel, slap corner, I'm at these. These are my old boys, don't at me, try gun leader, get shot from the backseat. Young wings are leaving us back, me best, your boss, I'm proud, I'm proud. The passy gon' get crispy, my boy, yeah, that's tough, he's a bomb, bomb, bomb.
In that crib session where, like, everyone was just spitting, but then you just see S just looking like into space kind of thing. Was that the moment where he realised that, yeah, like, he's going to get back?
Yeah, no, that was the moment, still. That was the moment. With SJ, obviously, I have a lot of friends in jail. But with SJ, this one kind of hit different because it was friends. I was friends with him way before I even knew most of the people I know now. You get from younger, so like, Yeah, it just hurts still.
Man, okay, he has like this unique flow that he's got in it. Loads of people sound similar, but his one's kind of very distinctive and you can pick it out and align it to him.
When it comes to flow, Bano's flow is nuts. Like, certain man ain't chatting to him about flows. Niggas don't even out here now, just catching his flow, but no bro's just letting him run with it, you know what I'm saying? Actually, man.
Huge impact. Yeah. Major.
Everyone's
major.
Using his flow.
Trust me, everyone. So you're saying he's got sons?
Little bandos, little SJs, little everything, man. You know what I'm saying? It's the flow. The flow. You know what I'm saying? It's like, I feel like, you see, like drill, I feel like there's two different age groups to drill. I feel like there's like me, Heady, Trap and that, and then there's like the diggers, bandos, dig that. Like.
Where do you see yourself in the drill? In the drill scene, like, how do you kind of view yourself compared to all like your peers in the scene?
Drill's not the same as how it was before. There's new instrumentals. There's more creative people coming out. So,
when you kind of see artists kind of saying, taking the flows that you kind of created, how does it make you feel as an artist?
I used to pre it sometimes, you know. Come on, don't show me homage when they're doing it. But then now, I don't really care. I just know that I created something within myself, if that makes sense. But mum's life, there's a lot of man. You get me? Can take you back to tunes and that. Like, using this flow, but just running with it in their own way. But it's calm. I just come with some new ones. I don't really feel like the scene take me in. How I'm meant to be taken in, if that makes sense. Like, I've gone far in this music thing, don't get it twisted, no, I'm not. You get me? But, like, yeah, man, it's where it is, though.
How did you approach it when you were in the booth? Like, even when you're writing your bars?
Should I be real, bro?
Yeah.
It's the weed. The weed just makes me think and just go crazy. That's just the honest truth, though. It's like when I'm in my mold and that. Yeah, it's a rap, man. But I just try to not rap. Not everyone else is rapping. But hold up, follow through your motors, your hashtag fucked, you will get soaked up. Police got pulled up, says he's a donut, ops 10 tweet, roll up. Understand what I'm saying, if not, get saved in. Kids locked up, I didn't get him on Irving. Escort, he got saved in, pretty amazing, burn not greetings. Babylon, try tag along, move out. Ops come true, shoot out, watch for the watch, lace it, shoes out, mama says something.
Did you see Bando getting to where he is today?
I didn't see it happening because I was in jail, innit? So like, obviously, before I went to jail, we did the crib session. OFB crib session, and then that was like one of the, like, I feel like the second or third video Bando did. Obviously, I went to jail for a year, but he was working, him, SJOs, and that, they were doing their thing for that whole year, innit? So when I came out, they was already doing their thing, you know what I'm saying? And then they just needed that, like, those in the game, they just needed that one tune, and then obviously they had Ambush, and then like the rest is history, you know what I'm saying?
Obviously, man can't tell into the future, but from young, when I used to get your music, like, he used to make music, but he used to hide it from us, but obviously I always get these music and that. Man was cold, like, I always used to think, like, see, us, like, from farm, all of us got our own little lingo, you get me?
Nah, I didn't see it, but I say it's a big blessing because he's changed his life around, he's become a big rapper now. These people's actors, you know what I'm saying?
From honest, no, but when he started rapping, yeah.
Bando is someone that's just full of hunger and excitement. So once he's kind of found his way into music, he's kind of brought that same character and mentality into it, and I guess that's why he's one of the superstars today. You know what I mean?
Facts, so.
You're now on your journey, on your solo career. What made you want to go solo?
When I was getting the shows, they're putting it as OFB.
Yeah, that's bro, I want to hear that.
Like, please. I want to see, you know what I'm saying, but OFB is a brand.
It's not you.
It's not just me.
Yeah, so you wanted to?
Yeah, I want to see my own name there. I don't have to split money no more as well. I just did music because I like music, bro.
Yeah.
So like, yeah, but I didn't really see like the potential in music because at one point I was just that kid on the block that weren't really allowed to do nothing, especially what I was rapping about as well. But I'm talking about me being young. Do you know what I mean? And when I say not allowed to do, not like that, but just for respect for my pops, and you know what I'm saying? But then obviously as I got older, I'm myself now.
Yeah.
And I'm just, yeah.
Why do you think the scene don't take you in, or haven't taken you in as the way they're supposed to be taking you in?
I don't know, you know, but one thing that really fucked up and slowed that man's thing was that Selfridges thing. And the way everyone portrayed, you know what I'm trying to say, like, me to be the bad guy, like, since then, no shows, no nothing, you get me? Bro, I was thinking, what the fuck? You get me, like, what's the link? Because I didn't know, I got arrested right after that, 5 minutes after it happened, straight away, did you get? I was in cells for the whole day of my birthday. I come out at like 11 p.m, got my phone, gone on Instagram, and I've seen flipping the Shade Borough. And then, yeah, from then I was thinking, it was what it is. I didn't think it was going to be this deep to affect my career like that.
I don't know if you catch it, but I don't know if I made it in time when I sent it to you, man. And I'm like, part by Tanji, Leo Spangy. You don't know that tune? Nah, I think that by the time I sent you the link, I made it after that store. Yeah, man, just... It's a booming store, can't even lie. Tune called Live, you get me? I think I just made for the project.
I think so.
Yeah, you just have to wait and see, man.
Yeah.
You get me? This track. I'm just freestyling some facts on the booth. Let's put it into a song.
Alright,
nothing more, nothing
well,
less.
Why, man?
Yo, we're the dots in the garden, barked off. Chap just barked off. Ops can't listen and back at the farm blocks. Ring like alarm clock. Son got hit by that. He was shot when the car stopped. Bucked into AB. Bands like crazy, he's driving. I know that his heart dropped. Paddy not star dogs. Strapped in the car. Was friends in a Bentley. Chucking the cars off.
At first, really, I was thinking, what should I call the tape? And someone just come to me with the idea. I was like, I like that. Get me made around Real Killers. It's the truth.
Everything's so real, you know?
So
I guess why even like what made you even think about like that from like the artwork as well?
Same thing, me and my manager were just flipping, thinking of what artwork to use and whatnot. The one day I just come to him like, oh, what if we just do like half of my face and half of my dad's face? It was getting bare with them sent in. But yeah, silly ones as well, and then yeah, that one just come through, and I was like, this is the one.
Alright, cool. We're now going to go on to the reactions about your pops and the riots as well.
For Mark Duggan, man, out there really, you know what I'm saying, for Bando, you know, like, he's lost someone big in his life.
Mm-hmm.
And like, when man was young, he was big dog on the block, you know what I'm saying, man's little dog, but trust me, man, yeah, he played a like, big part, like, in Broad Our Farms and Let Night. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Live a legend.
I used to look up to that man, but you get me. So when it happened and she said here it was as well, the police done it as well. The landlord's a strong guy, you get me? He's just kept it chill and look where he is now, you feel me? I was in the country when it happened. If I was, I was like crazy as well. For us, it was close to home, you feel me? Everyone felt it. So that's why it was real pain, innit? What happened in the end is literally real life.
It was a pinnacle situation that had an effect on so many people, do you know what I mean? And even till now today, you know, mm-hmm. Bando's forever making his dad proud, do you know what I mean? And he's gonna continue making him proud. He's definitely using the position that he is in to understand things that have happened and to persevere that through the music and just tell his story.
I got the call that there was protests going on the high road. The man was over there, obviously we can't really talk too much, car. It's a bit of a technical one. I feel like I had a big impact because I'd never seen him before, you know. And I say, like, I remember waking up the following morning and there was just like this, like just the air just felt different. Like the atmosphere was just, it was just like a hostile atmosphere.
He's just leveling up at the end of the day, like, even without a father. Like, get me? Just, it's hard to obviously live without a father, but
he's doing his thing.
He's doing his thing.
You get it, makes really that proud, you get.
Police, the government, whatever, they feel like they could just take the piss and do whatever and get away with it and no one can't chat to them.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So the fact that everybody came together as a community and said that, yo, this ain't right, and everyone stood up and did something. Yeah, yeah, I rate that still.
Were you realizing like the how mad the situation actually was as you were getting older and people were kind of talking to you about stuff?
I kind of understood it like when it first kind of happened, but I did start to realize it more as the years went by, and yeah.
And when you were understanding it, the more you understood it, was it more anger?
Yeah, the more I understood it, the more it hurt.
Yeah.
Yeah, just like that, the more I understood it, the more it hurt still.
And I guess those feelings that you had, the feelings that I guess you have surrounding it, do you ever think, like, why did this happen? Like, do you ever question anything? Do you ever, like...
I question it all the time. Because not like that, anyone can lose their father. Do you get it? But I feel like it's just the way I lost mine. By the police, you get. So yeah, just till now, just fucked up my head mentally, so.
And even with the police, like, your relationship with the police, what's that like?
I don't like the police. Police don't like me. Don't want to be doing these shows and that. So yeah, fuck them.
I mean, you not liking the police compared to like any of the man them or anyone else.
Yeah, my hate for police is different. I don't hate police just because they're police. We all know I hate police, but yeah.
Do you feel like you're making your dad proud as well?
I hope I am. Swear to you.
And even with like everything you're doing now with your career, is that who you feel like you're, is that who you're kind of doing it for now? Like how do you kind of, when you're kind of going about your life?
Yeah,
like
most definitely so. Yeah. There's been times like in my career when I'm thinking,
listening to this, go check my outro. They want Michael Myers loving how it sounds cold. I want a machine with a string, you know I'm about those. I know my bitch that suck dick can't keep her mouth closed. I'm in too deep to turn back now. I've seen a nigga go on live and get slapped out. Got Roar on the table with some Smackdown. I know it's called Aberdeen, I swear it should be called Cracktown. I'm in Jamaica by Tower Hill. Contract killers on standby, the Mac 10 is powerful. My gun on hip, string fast calling with my tower tool. It's their fault, not our fault, I'll see you in an hour's full. Brrr, boy, bands. Or should I tell them who I was or who I'm gonna be? I used to ride pedal bikes and do robberies. My girl said I'm involved, I told my bitch obviously. From Broadwell Farm, I love the block of B.